I'm Jack. In this video series, we will talk about WebGPU and how it affects web graphics programming, data visualization, and web gaming. WebGPU is a new web standard that allows developers to access GPU directly from the web browser for graphics and compute operations. This means that web developers can use modern GPUs to create high-performance web graphics, data visualizations, and web games. WebGPU is now widely available to developers through Chromium-based browsers like Chrome and Edge. This has important implications for web graphics programming. Previously, WebDL was used, which is a web standard that provides a JavaScript API for rendering 2D and 3D graphics. However, WebDL had limitations in terms of performance and flexibility. WebGPU overcomes these limitations by offering a more powerful and flexible graphics API that fully utilizes the GPU's capabilities. This allows web developers to create more complex and visually stunning web graphics that were not possible before. WebGPU can also benefit data visualization and web gaming. By offloading computationally intensive tasks to the GPU, developers can create more interactive and complex data visualizations and web games. These visualizations and games can handle larger datasets and provide real-time feedback, making them more immersive, engaging, and interactive. Overall, WebGPU is a significant advancement over WebDL. It offers a number of benefits that can improve the performance, flexibility, and capabilities of web graphics, data visualizations, and web games. In our previous video series, we covered the basics of graphics programming with WebGPU. However, both WebGPU and WDSL have undergone significant changes since then. Consequently, the application examples we discussed in that series will no longer function without updates. As WebGPU matures and gains stability, along with the official support for major web browsers, I am thrilled to announce a new video series on WebGPU. Throughout this series, I will guide you in creating a variety of advanced 3D graphics on the GPU. We will delve into topics such as super shapes, procedural terrains, complex function visualization, marching cubes, implicit 3D surfaces, amina graph, voxel terrains, and particle systems implemented using compute shaders. In this new video series, we will be utilizing the same development tools as in the previous video series. Specifically, we will be using Visual Studio Code as our code editor, TypeScript as our programming language, and Webpack as our module bundler. To conclude the introduction of this new video series, I would like to provide a sneak peek of the selected examples we will be creating in WebGPU. In this example, we will explore a parametric 3D surface, featuring a collection of 23 different surface types. The screen will showcase tens of thousands of surfaces implemented using instance drawing. You can select a specific surface to display from the drop-down menu. Additionally, you have the option to change the color map of the surfaces. And furthermore, you can choose to view the surface wireframe. Or both simultaneously. In this procedural terrain example, you have the ability to manipulate various parameters, including the water level. Scale. Level of detail, and more. Additionally, you can bring the terrain to life by animating it. Feel free to explore and customize the terrain to your liking. This is the voxel terrain created using marching cubes technique and compute shaders. This remarkable terrain offers a true 3D experience. You have the ability to animate it in various directions. By default, the animation is in the Z direction, but you can also explore animation in the X and Y directions. This is the 3D volcano example. Take a closer look and discover the backside as well. Prepare to be amazed by the intricate details and immersive experience. In this example, we will explore various complex functions using domain coloring. This technique vividly displays the zeros and poles of each function. You can select different functions to visualize and even customize the color map of the image. Next, we have an example showcasing the electric field distribution of moving point charges. You have the flexibility to adjust the number of point charges, allowing for dynamic exploration of the electric field. Moving on, we delve into a gravity simulation on a 2D grid, accompanied by diverse textures. The simulation features four mass centers that move over time. By manipulating the textures, time steps, and texture coordinates, you can alter the distribution of gravitational force. Additionally, you can switch the force from default attraction to repulsion. The resulting gravity force on the 2D grid generates a remarkably beautiful image. These are just a few selected examples of what we'll be creating in this video series. Throughout the series, I will guide you in creating even more fascinating WebGPU applications. With that, we will conclude today's video. In the next installment, I will provide a comprehensive walkthrough on creating these stunning 3D graphics using WebGPU. Remember to stay tuned for the upcoming video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.